If you're a magician, the one thing that you need more than anything else is a wand. And you may wonder, well, where do wands come from? Well, of course, they have to be manufactured. And for that, you need a very special machine. In fact, here it is. It's a special magic wand machine. It looks quite large for to make something as small as a magic wand. But then, of course, there's an awful lot of magic that actually goes on. You might think, well, you're not quite sure what you're paying your money for when you buy one of these, because when you open it up, it looks as if you're getting absolutely nothing for your money. But, in fact, it works extremely well. I'm going to try and show you exactly how it works. So, on here we've got the cogs, we've got a nice noisy handle, and to start off with, you need something that looks a bit like a wand. Now, there are two things wrong with this. It's the right material, it's made of wood, but it's square at the ends, so it's got these hard, these sharp edges instead of being nice and circular. And of course, it's not coloured in any way. We want it to have black and white. So, the first thing to do is to put it into the machine, which I will do like that. And then we close it up and we get somebody up to come and wind the handle. I think three times should be just about enough. We'll give it a little bit more, just in case. Open it up again, and ooh, and look at that. We've actually got a wooden wand, which is now circular. So we're on the way. Now the next thing to do to make it look like a wand is actually give it some colour. And for that we need some white paint for the ends, and some black paint for the middle. So back it goes inside the machine, give the item some paint. We need a little funnel first of all, a little bit of white, not sure how much to put in, we'll just put a very little in, and some black. Wonder if that was too much. Anyway, we'll see in a moment. Take out that, give it a good stir, and let's see how we've got on. So we reach inside. Ah, I don't think we've got our quantities quite right yet, because we've got a black wand, which is well on the way, but it's got no white on it. So let's pop that back in. And this time we'll put no more black paint inside. We'll just put some white. Perhaps you can tell me how much you think I ought to put in. Think that's enough? You think I put too much in? Okay, we'll see. Let's have a look. Don't forget, of course, it's magic paint, so you can't actually see it. Give it a good stir, and the black wand has now become, what has it become? It's become a white wand. I think we've used a little bit too much, don't you? Now, there's always somebody at this point who thinks that I'm actually cheating slightly, and that there is actually something inside the machine. So just to prove that there isn't, if I open it up again, you can see that there really is nothing inside at all. Nothing that you can see. So, close it one more time, turn it round to face me. We'll take the white wand and try and get this right. Pop it back inside. Now I need to get my quantities right this time. I put in rather too much white last time, so we won't put any more white in. We'll just put a little black paint. I think that's enough. Difficult to tell, isn't it? Give it a stir. And when we reach inside, what have we got? We have got a black and white wand. A lovely black... Well, I suppose you call that white and black, wouldn't you, rather than black and white? Because there's rather too much white there. Maybe we ought to give it a bit of a proper stir this time. Back it goes inside. And I won't put any more paint inside. Instead, we'll just give it a... Have a little peep. A bit more. I think I'll just give it a little bit of a slosh around to get that paint working. Reach inside. Well, it's black and white, sure enough. But I don't think we should have sloshed it around quite so much, because now we've got a spotted one. You can't use a spotted one, can you? We'll shake it up and down this time. So, in it goes. Quick stir. Shake it up and down. Hope that's enough. Open it up, and we have now got a striped. Well, this would be great if we were doing a trick with a zebra, wouldn't it? Or with a zebra crossing, but unfortunately we're not. And I don't think that's quite what we wanted. But the one thing we haven't done is actually use a magic smell, have we? That's what I said, a magic smell. Oh, what did you say? Oh, spell! It's very difficult operating when you've got absolutely nobody in the room apart from the cameraman who has heard these jokes several times before. So, what we need at this point is to cast a magic spell. And what's today's magic word going to be? Hocus pocus? All right, we'll try hocus pocus. In goes the wand, the strike wand, and we'll give it a really good stir this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All say the magic word together. Hocus pocus. What a lot of noise that was. And do you know what? It's actually worked. We have got the wand that we wanted that we can use throughout the rest of the show. Absolutely perfect, all thanks to you. And that is down to this very clever wand machine, which started empty, finishes empty. That is the magic wand machine.